expand the hands thereby on the guests by Patrick and Denyse. If you would, if you have any cell phone, ask that you put them on vibrate and prepare them to activate. Yeah. I want to greet you all and thank my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And as a priest and honorary guest of the Holy Spirit. So we're gathered together to witness the ceremony and the holy matrimony of Anthony and Kevin Morris. Marriage is honorable. Marriage is the oldest institution that God has ordained. Marriage is something that any of us, or you should not go into lightly, but go into reverently, advisedly, and asking that God would unite you in this marriage. Marriage is honorable in all. And the being under vow, Hebrews 13 and 4 tells us that, according to the word of God and the minister, marriage is honorable between a man and a woman. So we are here to unite you with Patrick in marriage. And so I want to pray now and ask God's blessing upon this marriage. Almighty and dear Father, we come to you in the humblest way that we know how and have been taught. We come to you in the name given unto men, in no name given unto men, whereby that we may be saved, and that's in Jesus Christ. We come now asking for strength for this couple as they have come together in hope and faith and in love. To come to stand before you and these witnesses that are here today to say their vows and their pledges and to bring themselves together to make their marriage and a home acceptable in your sight. Give them strength now, Lord, to say their pledges and their vows, and give them strength, Lord, to understand the seriousness of the marriage, in a marriage, let them know that so many times the marriage is always under attack by Satan, but we have God, the Holy Spirit, to give them strength. So we pray for strength, that you give them strength, and that you allow them to have a happy home, and that they would grow in peace and love and kindness and respect one for another. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. We thank you for bringing them together. And we thank you for this wedding ceremony. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. We have the honor of giving Kerry Patrick.
We do.
This time, we will have a scripture reading by Patrick and one by Kenny Jones. We want you to take the time to listen to the choice words of their children, the word of God.
It's a message from the groom. The Lord has sent Denyse to me to make me full and whole in his eyes. Denyse and I thank you for sharing our love. We look forward to continuing our walk with God, and we count his blessings every day. Song of Solomon, chapter 2, verse 10 through 13. My beloved spake and said unto me, Rise up, my love, my fair one, and come away. For lo, the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of the singing of the birds is come, and the voice of the turtle is heard in our land. The fig tree putteth forth her green figs, and the vines with tender grape give a good smell. Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away.
This is a message from the bride. I know I am blessed because I know God's love. The Lord has shown me through my personal journey, both previous and now with Patrick, that love truly is the greatest of all. For this reason, I have selected 1 Corinthians 13th chapter, verse 8 through 13, to share with everyone gathered here today. 1 Corinthians 13, 8 through 13. Charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether they be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is imperfect shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. But when I became a man, I put away such childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, charity. The greatest of those is charity.
Amen. I not charge you both. You stand in the presence of God at this assembly to remember that the love and the faithful observance of your marriage vows are required as the foundation of a successful marriage and the establishment of a happy and enduring home. Without these, there can be no your marriage, and the home that you endeavor to establish will be in vain. Improve this effort. And remember that you and the niece are marrying each other. You're not marrying your family. You're establishing your own family. So you are to hold one another, cherish one another, respect one another, and build one another up. Keep the solemn vows you are about to make. Live in tender consideration of each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth. Your marriage will last, and your home will endure. The marriage bond will be a blessing to you, and you will be a blessing to others. This should be remembered as you declare your desire to wed one another. Remember, you will be a blessing to yourselves and a blessing to one another. You keep these vows. Patrick, will you have Kelly Denyse, Kelly Morgan, to be your wedded wife, to live together in the covenant of faith, hope, and love according to the intention of God for your lives together in Jesus Christ? Will you listen to her innermost thoughts? Be considerate and tender in your care of her, and stand by her faithfully in sickness and in health, and preferring her above all others, that accept full responsibility for every necessity as long as you both shall live. Say it loud.
I will.
Get it marked in these tones, right? Kelly and Margie Denyse. You have Will you have Patrick to be your wedded husband, to live together in the covenant of faith, hope, love, according to the intention of God for your lives together in Jesus Christ? Will you listen to his innermost thoughts, be considerate and tender in your care of him, and stand by him faithfully in sickness and in health, and preferring him above all others, accept full responsibility for his every necessity, as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Since they have made this, accepted the pledge, I would ask the question, if there is anyone here who knows any reason why these two should be joined together, let them speak now, or forever hold their peace. Thank you. Since it is your desire, in your expressed desire to be wedded, I am now asking you to join your right hands. And repeat after me in question and answer. Patrick, in the name of Jesus, repeat after me,
in the name of Jesus,
I, Patrick Kevin Arnold. Thank you, Kevin, Morgan, Jones, Denyse.
Thank you, Kevin, Morgan, Denyse, Wright, Jones.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For richer.
For poor.
In sickness.
And in health.
To love.
Honor.
And cherish.
For as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow. Kevin Martin, please repeat after me. In the name of Jesus.
I, Kelly Morgan.
Thank you, Patrick.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
Better.
For worse.
For richer.
For poor.
In sickness.
And in health.
To love.
Honor.
And cherish.
For as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow. What do you give as a token of your love? Kelly and Patrick, what do you give as a token for your love? It is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual love, which unite two loyal hearts, your hearts, in trust and endless love. Don't forget that. Patrick, as you place the ring on Kelly Morgan's left hand, third finger, will you repeat after me? I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. Kelly, as you place the ring on the left finger, the third finger of Patrick, will you repeat after me? I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and faithfulness to you. Kelly Morgan, Bible teaches us that in marriage, two become one flesh. In the symbol of this evolution, we use now light the unity candle.
Everybody can see me.
Come on, Brian. You need to stand right in front of me, baby.
Oh, okay. That's all right.
That's your answer.
That's fine.
Right, come stand with me.
Oh, we'll set you. We'll set you.
Yeah, he can put the broom down.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Now, give me your hand.
Yeah.
And take it. Turn around. Turn around. There you go.
Thank you.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for bringing us here, Lord, for this great occasion. Father God, we pray over the food today, Lord. We pray that you bless him. In your son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
One more time, put your hands together. Come on.
The new Mr. and Mrs. Arnold up here to cut their cake tonight.
Thank you.
my sister, Denyse. Most of you know her as family. She's Kelly. And Patrick, congratulations. I'm glad that you guys finally made it to this day, and I hope that you have many more just like this. To the bride and groom.
All right, and the best man, come on up.
Well, I have to admit, it's nice to see Pat finally get married before me. And I wish you all the best and enjoy it. I'm not telling any stories. Thank you.
All right.
Bride and groom would like to ask all of you to join them on the dance floor for the song. This is an open dance for everybody, so please come out and join them so Patrick doesn't have to be embarrassed. He doesn't like to dance. So all of you, please join them on the dance floor.
Yeah.
I'm shaking it, just like a pile of rubber band. I'm shaking the city like crazy.
The bride and groom, a little Rascal Flatts. This is a couple's dance.
I got shot down.
Ladies, to stay on the dance floor because it is time for the bouquet toss. All right, ladies, get ready. Get those hands in the air.
I can see everybody, so I know that.
Okay, all right, ready to do this, Denyse? Okay, on the count of three. Ladies, get ready. Taking it from the back.
kids are. I'm happy. Let's get a picture with a winner. You know what that means. Next year, we're going to be at your wedding. Alright, are you ready? Guys, get ready. On the count of three. One, two, three. Alright. Come back. Winner, come back. We need a picture with the winner.
When I'm lying in my bed, thoughts are running through my head.
Thank you, Denyse.
Some people live for the fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power, yeah. Some people live just to play the game. Some people think that the physical thing define what's within, and I've been there before. But that life's a bore, so full of the superficial. Search for a fountain. The promise is forever young. You know, some people need 3 dozen roses, and that's the only way to prove you love them. Hand me the world on a silver platter. And some people want it all, but I don't want baby. Oh, ooh, said nothing in this whole